एंड टीचिंग ट्रेडिंग आइडिया और थियोरी डेवलप बाई लेजेंडरी ट्रेडर कॉल्ड डब्ल्यू डी जान. यू वुड हैव हर्ड दिस नेम समवेयर और द अदर. ही इज ऑल्सो डेवलप्ड अ फ्यू इंडिकेटर्स इन दिस टाइम एज अ ट्रेडर. सो टुडे विल बी गोइंग इन टू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ समथिंग ही कॉल्ड टाइम साइकिल्स एंड हाउ द स्टॉक मार्केट रिपीट्स इटसेल्फ ओवर टाइम. सो द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फोरकास्टिंग, ही सेड दैट एवरी मूवमेंट इन द मार्केट इज ऑफ नेचुरल लॉ एंड द कॉज विच एग्जिस्ट लॉन्ग बिफोर द इफेक्ट इवन टेक्स प्लेस एंड कैन बी डिटरमाइंड इयर्स इन एडवांस. द फ्यूचर इज बट अ रिपीटेशन ऑफ द पास्ट. सो हिज थियोरी बेसिकली सेज दैट द स्टॉक मार्केट मूव्स इन साइकिल्स एंड वॉट हैज हैपेंड इन द पास्ट विल हैपन इन द फ्यूचर अगेन. सो देर आर मेनी मेजर साइकिल्स ही हैज डेवलप्ड. ही हैज अ 24 ईयर साइकिल, अ 60 ईयर साइकिल, अ 90 ईयर साइकिल. बट टुडे वीड बी डिस्कसिंग सम द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ हिज थियोरी. सो देर मस्ट बी अ मेजर एंड अ माइनर, अ ग्रेटर एंड अ लेसर, अ पॉजिटिव एंड अ नेगेटिव. In order to be accurate in forecasting the future, you must know the major cycles. The most money is made when fast moves and extreme fluctuations occur at the end of major cycles. So this must be a little confusing. I will show to you guys what all this means in a while. I have experimented and compared past markets in order to locate the major and minor cycles and determine what years in the cycles repeat in the future. After years of research and practical tests, he has discovered these cycles. So these major and minor cycles he's talking about happen over decades and lot of years. So the minor cycles we will be looking into today for now. So you guys need to remember these four main dates: the 21st of December, 23rd of March, 21st of June, and 23rd of September. So these four dates were the major are the major years for the minor cycles to occur repeatedly. Now let us look at the charts of Nifty and see if this works or not. So today is the 10th of March. So let me write down these 21st December, 23rd March, 21st June and 23rd September. So the previous year date was on 21st of December, which is right here. And you can see how the markets had formed a top on that exact day, this candle. So this level markets had formed a top. You had no sign of reversal all this way. It was a very bullish run. And then suddenly on the 23rd of December, you can see the sudden sell-off. And we go to the previous day, the 23rd of March. As we all know, this is the 23rd of September. So this was the 23rd of September, and you can clearly see that markets had formed bottom on the 23rd of September, which wasn't broken, and you can see the amazing bull run after that. Now the previous date before that is the 21st of June. Again, clearly you can see that this blue arrow, as this blue arrow indicates, markets formed a top on that very day, and then the reverse from there. And then the 23rd of March, exactly when the coronavirus crash stopped and the market reversed from there, and that low is still hasn't been broken. Now this analysis I have done for the past 5 years, as you can see, again this is the 21st of December, markets formed a top and gave a good fall. Again this 23rd of September, again you can see there was a huge fall after the 23rd of September, almost 4% correction. This 21st of June. So this again, markets formed a bottom here, 21st of June. That level was not breached for a while, and we had a 3%, 2-3% rise. Again, markets here have formed a top and fell down. This was the 23rd of March again. So this is not 100% accurate. Obviously, nothing can be 100% accurate. Again, another main level was formed on the 21st of December, and you can see that the markets struggled a lot to breach that. Now, these are a few failed cases. Here, this was the 21st of September, which failed, and the markets were looking to form a bottom, but they couldn't. And here again, the 21st of June, markets didn't reverse from that date. Again, another very good example, 23rd of March. And this is in 2018, markets formed a bottom and shot up from there. So this was another one of the few failed cases. So till now, we have had three failed cases in total. This date again, 21st of September, you can see clearly what happened. Market had formed a top and a good fall. Exactly, again, the same thing here. This was the 21st of June. Again here, this was the 23rd of March. This blue arrow indicates that markets had formed the bottom and bounced up. Look at this huge rally from 23rd of March. There was a very good rally. And then again, markets had failed to form the bottom out. They failed to bottom out here on this day, 21st December. This was 21st December, but the markets continued falling. So this is our fourth failed case here. And we have come till 2016. I will backtest this for 5 years right here, right in front of you. Now, again, this was 23rd of September. Market formed a clear top and fell all the way down. Another good example, 23rd of June. 21st of June, my bad. And then markets give a good fall of about 3-4%. Again, here markets formed a top and again corrected almost 2-3% again. Here again, this was the 21st of December. You can see a good rally. Markets bottomed out here and there was a good rally. Here again, I'll just mark out the regions for you where it reversed off. This was, I backtested till 2015. You can go further back if you want to. I went even when the market, long periods ago, when the market started. Can even go back there. This is 2000, and you can see even here, this was 21st of June. You can look at this, and then this was the next day, December 21st. You can see the rise after that. That level was not broken for a long time after 21st December. Another top formation right here, and then markets fell. If we even go when the chart started initially, there's literally no data here. This is 1995. You can see that. In December, 21st of December, what had happened? Now this crash may not seem huge, but in terms of percentages, it is almost 10%, 10-12%. So this is the theory which has worked brilliantly and will continue to keep working in the future as well. Because Jahn theory states that what happens in the future will happen, and what happened in the past will happen in the future again. So in the past 5 years, it had worked 16 out of 20 times successfully. So that is an 80% rate, which very few trading strategies have that kind of accuracy. So we could put an RSI indicator here on the charts also for a second confirmation. And you can see that on the dates of reversal, RSI had formed tops too and was in the overbought region. Here it's touching 80 here. It's touching 30 here on this date. On this date again, it's touching 70. So RSI is also, it was hugely oversold here on 23rd March. So you could take confirmation from RSI also as to go short or long. Now the next upcoming date would be 23rd of March. Now I'm recording this on 10th of March, so 23rd of March could either form a bottom or a top of the market. We could decide based on where RSI is and how the markets act up in the next 1 week. So depending on that, if on 23rd March, you could either buy one lot of 14,000 PE or 16,000 CE. So these are far out of the money, April expiry options. So This is trading around 87.55, the put option, and the call option at 136. So you could buy one lot and just try this trading strategy out. It has worked in 2020 and 2021 very well. We could have made good money if we knew about this strategy. So this, there's nothing 100% right. So this is a very high probability setup and it's a multi-bragger trading idea. So you could, on the 22nd of March, one day before, you could either purchase this put or call options depending on the market and the conditions. And that's it for today. Thank you.